Welcome to the session, Meaning, Definition and Concepts of Education. Introduction and History of Education. From the beginning of man's existence, each generation, irrespective of geography or culture, has devised various ways to pass on their cultural and social values, traditions, morality, religion, and skills to the future generations. So, when one talks about the history of education, one is essentially talking about the history of teaching and learning that has been happening across geographies and cultures over the centuries. A study of the history of the scope of such education encompasses human history itself, including the history of knowledge, beliefs, skills, and cultures. Two other terms that are commonly used in the context of passing on culture, social values, and accepted behaviors are enculturation and socialization. The term enculturation denotes the passing of established culture, while the term socialization denotes learning of social values and behaviors. In pre-literate societies, education was transmitted orally from the older generation to the younger generation through informal interactions with family members and by observation and imitation. At a later stage in their lives, the young received a more structured and formal form of instruction in the context of initiation, religion, or ritual. This form of instruction was not necessarily imparted by immediate family, but by the other members of the society. With the passage of time, customs and knowledge followed by civilization become more complex, and along with the traditions and customs, newer skills also had to be passed on to the next generation. Animal husbandry, agriculture, fishing, food preparation and preservation, construction, stonework, metalwork, boat building, making of weapons, military skills, and other occupational skills had to be passed on to the next generation from people experienced in the particular job. With the advent of writing, recording, and passing on of stories, poetry, knowledge, beliefs and customs more accurately to a wider circle of community members and future generations become possible. However, it took many centuries and in the case of some societies, even many millennia before the spread of literacy. Illiteracy continued to be widely prevalent for much of the human population. Literacy in pre-industrial societies was associated with civil administration, law, long-distance trade or commerce, and religion and formal schooling in literacy was accessible to only a very privileged and small part of the population. This type of formal education was imparted at religious institutions or through personal tutors, who could be hired only by the extremely wealthy segment of the population. The practice of universal education of all children in literacy has been a relatively recent development. In many countries, educating children in literacy did not begin until after 1850 CE. Even today, in some countries, literacy rates continue to be below 60%. The earliest centers of higher education, like universities, started functioning only about a millennium or more ago. Schools, colleges, and universities have not been the only methods followed since the establishment of formal education and training. In Europe and many other countries, from the Middle Ages until recent time, the skills of a trade were not generally learned in a classroom, but rather by serving an apprenticeship. Today, formal education has become synonymous with systematic instruction, teaching, and training by professional teachers. The foundation of this form of education is based on the application of pedagogy and the development of curricula. Definition. Origin. The etymological origin of the word education is from the Latin word educare, which means bring up. The term educare is related to the term educare, which means bring out, bring forth what is within, bring out potential, and to desire, which means to lead. In the Roman language, the verb educare means to bring up, rear, train, raise, support, etc. The word education has many definitions. The three most common definitions being 1. The act or process of imparting or acquiring general knowledge, developing the powers of reasoning and the judgment, and generally of preparing oneself or others intellectually for mature life. 2. The act or process of imparting or acquiring particular knowledge or skills as for a profession. 3. A degree, level, or kind of schooling, a university education. Education, in the truest sense of the word, is any act or experience that has a formative effect on the mind, character, or physical ability of an individual. It is the process by which society deliberately passes on its accumulated knowledge, skills, and values to its future generations. There are a number of synonyms of the word education. The word pedagogy is derived from two Greek words. This word means to lead people. In India, word used to denote education is vidya. This is a Sanskrit word and it means to know. If we look at these different words in different languages and their meanings, we can understand that education is a very complex idea that involves knowing, learning, rising people, and something that brings out the inner person. The scope of education is not covered by any of the single term that is used to denote education. Process. Education is not a single process. As the different meanings of the word suggest, it involves a number of processes. Three processes are central to the concept of education. They are teaching, instruction, and learning. Instruction is a broad term that refers to the facilitating of learning. This facilitating is done in education by a tutor or teacher. Teaching is a term that refers to the actions performed by an instructor. Teaching is an action done with the aim of imparting learning to the student. Learning is a process of acquiring the benefit of teaching and instruction. This refers to specific knowledge, skills, or abilities that can be applied upon completion by those who have been taught. It is the act, process, or experience of gaining knowledge or skill. Education is a triangular process. It involves the interplay of three things: educator, educated, and social forces. These three processes are very much central to any concept of education in any culture. Though the idea of education differs from society to society and from culture to culture, these three processes constitute education. Philosophers on education. There is a vast diversity of beliefs and opinions about the meaning and purpose of education arising from the values and experiences of individuals and the societies to which they belong. There is no singular definition of education that is agreed upon by even educators. While some focus on knowledge, others on the teacher, and some others on the development of the student. In spite of this, Pupils' beliefs in the purpose of education are central to their teaching behaviors. Socrates saw education as something that imparts certain capacities to human beings. He viewed that education gives man certain qualities and helps him live lives in a better way than others do. According to Socrates, the educated are those who manage well the circumstances they encounter day by day, those who are decent, those who are honorable in their intercourse with all men, those who are bearing easily and good-naturedly what is offensive in others, those who are being as agreeable and reasonable to their associates, those who hold their pleasures always under control, those who are not ultimately overcome by their misfortunes, those who are not spoiled by their successes, those who do not desert their true selves, those who hold their ground steadfastly as wise and sober-minded men. Jean-Jacques Rousseau believed that education is something that helps the mental, spiritual, and material growth of human beings. In his On Philosophy of Education, he says that everything we do not have at birth and which we need when we are grown is given to us by education. Aristotle emphasizes the importance of education when he said that all who have meditated on the art of governing mankind have been convinced that the fate of empires depends on the education of youth. He saw education as a tool with which the state can mold and govern individuals and citizens. We can see that this is true even today. Education is one of the best tools with which the government tries to mold dutiful citizens. And that is precisely why education is given prime importance in the agenda of all governments and political systems all over the world. Swami Vivekananda said that education is the manifestation of divine perfection already existing in man. Aristotle saw education as something that contributes to both the soul and the body. He believed education is the creation of a sound mind in a sound body. By education, Gandhi meant the all-round drawing out of the best in a man and a child. Like many great thinkers, prophets, and philosophers, Mahatma Gandhi was convinced that injustice, violence, and oppression manifest from human heart and that education can play an effective role in developing a wholesome human personality, capable of resisting war, violence, injustice, and oppression and building a social order wherein man can live in peace and harmony with others. His faith in education as a powerful instrument of man-making and social engineering, he called for a system of education that could draw out the best in the child, body, mind, and spirit for developing a peace-loving human personality. The Gandhian philosophy of education, if practiced in the right manner, can transform the destiny of men and nation and help establish an alternative social order. We can find that the opinions of the scholars and philosophers vary from time to time and from culture to culture. Types of education. Education is a process that human beings have to undergo at different stages and at different age. Education has different levels, and these levels are meant to meet the needs of an individual at the different levels of his growth. The major levels of education are primary or elementary education, secondary education, higher education, adult education, alternative education, and indigenous education. The term primary or elementary education is used to describe the first consists of 6 or 8 years of schooling starting at the age of 5 or 6. The age for primary education varies from country to country and sometimes within countries. Statistics show that globally around 89% of primary age children are believed to be enrolled in primary education under the Education for All program driven by UNESCO. Most countries have committed to achieving universal enrollment in primary education by 2015, and in many countries it is compulsory for children to receive primary education. Secondary education comprises the formal education that occurs during adolescence. The purpose of secondary education is to impart common knowledge to prepare for higher education or to train directly in a profession. It is characterized by transition from primary education or minors to the optional higher education for adults. Depending on the system, schools for this period may be called secondary or high schools. The exact boundary between primary and secondary education also varies from country to country, but it is generally around the 7th to the 10th year of schooling. Higher education generally involves work towards a degree level or foundation degree qualification. In most developed countries, as much as 50% of the population now enters higher education at some time in their lives. Higher education is therefore playing a significant role in national economies, both as an industry in its own right and as a source of trained and educated personnel for the rest of the economy. Adult education has now become a common phenomenon in many countries. This can be acquired through various channels, from formal class-based learning to self-directed learning and internet-based learning. A major share of adult education is taken up by career-specific courses. Alternative education is a broad term that encompasses all forms of education outside the traditional form of education. This term may refer to not only forms of education designed for students with special needs, but also forms of education employing alternative educational philosophies and methods designed for general audiences. The indigenous model of education aims to contribute to the success of members of indigenous communities using alternate methods and content within the scope of existing formal and informal education systems. Several members of indigenous communities are choosing to access and contribute to this system of education, both as student learners and as teachers or instructors. Module 4, different concept of education. The Vedic concept of education. The Vedic concept of education places emphasis on the nurturing of human values and concern for fellow beings. This is considered a critical facet of true knowledge seeking and giving. The roles of teacher and student are very well defined, and the ideal guru and shishya are required to possess certain characteristics. For example, a good teacher should have faith in the inherent potentialities of each and every student, while being able to recognize the differences in their capacity of assimilation. A teacher should have love for knowledge and should read new books, acquire new dimensions of knowledge, and constantly enrich himself with new ideas. And this capacity to acquire knowledge must be combined with the capacity to communicate knowledge to others. An ideal teacher is supposed to be a friend, philosopher, and guide who motivates the student to be interactive in the classroom. He questions his students and encourages them to express their opinions. To teach is to learn. Hence, the ideal teaching learning process is not a one-way traffic. It is intended for the welfare of both teacher and student. Lethargy and complacency were considered the greatest hindrances in the process of learning. It was considered the duty of man to move ahead in his quest for knowledge. Vedas prescribed the study of books of divine knowledge, books that purify all beings, books that have been preserved by the enlightened sages and seers, enjoys celestial bliss, attains purity and piety. Gurukula, Guru Shishya, Parabrahma are some familiar terms denoting the setting for teacher-student interactions and social stratification in ancient Indian literature. In the Vedas, the interactions of the teacher-student are governed by the principle of Acharya Devo Bhava, Islamic concept of education. The Arabic term for knowledge is ilm. This term has much wider connotation than its synonyms in English and other Western languages. Ilm is an all-embracing term covering theory, action, and education when compared to knowledge in the Western world, which means information about something divine or corporeal. The importance of this term in Muslim civilization and Islam is very high, and this makes Islamic education distinctive. Knowledge is considered of supreme value for Muslim intellectual, religious, and political life. Even the daily life of an average Muslim is touched by the concept of ilm. Some have even equated the concept of ilm with Islam, even if all theologians have not been enthusiastic about accepting this equation. The very fact that this concept is a passionate topic for discussion underlines its fundamental importance for Islam. Western concept of education. Western education began within hunter-gatherer societies and spread to most developed countries by the 19th century. In hunter-gatherer societies or pre-literal societies, education involved teaching children essential hunter-gatherer skills through mimicry and oral transfer of information from capable members of the group. Pre-industrial or agricultural societies came into being about 10,000 years ago and appeared in Western civilization around 500 BC. The Western practice of agriculture gained monument around 52 BC as the Romans became increasingly sophisticated at cultivating the land and domesticating the animals. Western education within agricultural societies was more complex when compared to hunter-gatherer societies. To facilitate division of labor, groups of people with particular set of skills had to be identified and trained. Education came in the form of learning a trade, accompanied with a considerable investment of time to achieve competence. Advancement in agriculture technology also led to the creation of dense communities, exchange of ideas, and sharing of ideas. This had a profound significance on the concept of education. The Socratic method of education is a term denoting a debate between opposing viewpoints characterized with a robust exchange of questioning and answering, encouraging the use of logic. The Socratic method is a favored teaching within modern educational institutions, especially within Western law schools. Plato, a student of Socrates, founded the Platonic Academy. the first institution for higher education in Western civilization. The curriculum included study of logic, mathematics, science, and natural philosophy. Plato's academy closely resembled the formal classroom structure of today, involving lecturing, questioning, and answering, with emphasis on orderly contact and classroom structure. Modern Western education favors the Platonic model and is usually provided by governmental institutions up to a certain age. Within the Western world, education became widespread and even mandatory in most developed countries by the 19th century. Now, we can summarize the major points discussed in this session. This unit tried to lay out the complex ideas and meanings of the word education carries. We have seen in this unit that education is not a single process, but a mixture of complex multiple processes. Education cannot be easily defined either. The definition of education varies from country to country and from culture to culture. Eastern cultures and Western cultures see education somewhat differently. In the case of India, the British colonialism brought Western ideas of education into the country. The scholars who have spoken about the idea of education saw it as both as an individual and a social betterment tool. This betterment is attained through subjecting an individual to different types of education at different stages in his or her life. Hope that you can answer the following questions here. How was education done in pre-literate societies? What is the etymological origin of the word education? What is the Gandhian idea of education? What is the teacher-student relationship in the Vedic concept of education? What is the indigenous model of education? Now you can refer the books given here for further reading. References: John Dewey, Experience and Education, Free Press, 1997. Randall R. Curran, A Companion to the Philosophy of Education, Malden, M.A., Blackwell, 2003. Asha S. Novels, The International Encyclopedia of Higher Education, London, Josie Buss, 1977. Hope that this session was beneficial to you. We will meet again with another topic. Thank you.